Over the weekend, what I got up to? I went to Inferno. And by their Instagram bio, they are a London-based queer techno rave performance art platform founded and curated by Lewis G. Burton. And oh my God, was it fun? Was it fun? Legitimately, one of the funnest raves I've been to in a long time. And again, it wasn't rambunctious. It wasn't wall-to-wall people. It wasn't like all the music I'm pretty much used to. It was a completely different crowd, but it was legitimately one of the funnest places I've been to. And even though everyone looks incredibly cool and you'd think they're going to be really pretentious and up their own ass, it might have been, on my, again, my opinion still. Again, I've been to many raves, so I don't know how many you want to take my opinion, you know, as gospel or whatever. I legitimately think this might have been the nicest group of people I've ever met in a party, especially in a party that I felt, you know, severely underdressed in, right? Something that I felt inadequate in, actually. I actually feel like, God damn it, man, I should have made an effort. Like, such a good party, such a fun party. First of all, it's located at the Colour Factory, formerly known as Mixed Garage, which is in Hackney Wick. Nice little area there, little square where there's nice little clubs. There's the yard, there's that, there's Colour Factory. There's a crepe pub that does also great pizzas. There's down the road another bar too. I forgot the name of it, but it's a cool little square. If you want to go out to rave and hang out, have a good time in East London, I really recommend going that little Hackney Wick area. So I've been going to the Colour Factory, or formerly Mixed Garage, for a while now. When it was Mixed Garage, they had mostly, you would say, your typical kind of Night Tales kind of promotion. I would imagine whoever does Night Tales probably was the same booker that did Mixed Garage, because the nights were fairly simple, right? Like, deep house, techno sort of nights playing there. So kind of the familiar sort of lineup. But whoever took over the Colour Factory has definitely decided to flip it on its head and change the entire booking, because all I see are all these kind of, what I would term to be, again, no, it's not to be derogatory, it's just kind of how I would class it, quote unquote, alternative club nights. But they're also giving them the platform to do it at that kind of level, at that scale, in those kind of clubs. Because usually these kind of nights at Inferno would usually, in the times gone by when I was coming up promoting nights, they would usually be in pubs and bars, right? They'd be like in, you'd go, you'd hire a pub and a bar, you'd get your own door staff, and you kind of make your own little thing. But you'd rarely see these kind of parties at like a Corsica, at like an Esco, XOYO, and E1, at a Fabric, at a Fold. They didn't really happen, no, not Fold's not a good example, but you know what I mean? They didn't really happen in those kind of spaces. That's why probably the places like the Cores are so important, because they are really good at sort of having an extremely varied lineup, right? They go from drum and bass to jungle, to bass, to disco, to house, to techno, all of it covered. But most clubs are not like that. Most clubs kind of stick to the what's tried and true, like all the Resident Advisor Top 100 DJ list or DJ Mag Top 100 list kind of music, right? Deep house, variations, and then all the other spaces do all the other quote alternative nights. But it's really great to see these spaces allow people like this to be able to put on nights at the level or on the same platform as all these other big kind of promotions, to basically prove the concept that as long as these people are able to apply themselves, as long as you're able to play on the same field, you can also compete. Because I think for a long time people would think, these people who are playing at these sort of nights are not at the level of those bigger DJs playing at the bigger festivals. That's why they're playing at that level. No, it's not because of that. It's because the system is rigged for the most part. There's a kind of, it's sort of like a gated institution, right? I wouldn't call it a boys club, but it is a little bit like, you know, if you know somebody, you get in that way. I've heard of DJs making it, like there's one good example, I forgot the DJ's name, who was essentially a dealer of somebody in a deep house scene, or in a techno, deep house scene. So there's a big DJ in there. His dealer basically started getting interested into DJing because of just dealing to this guy. Started DJing on the side, just as a hobby. And then because he's known to the DJ guy, he got a booker too. And now he's like, you know, touring the world and living his best life. But only because he kind of has that kind of in. So it's not really, you can't say it's always earned. It's kind of like favors. It is what it is. But then what I would always argue is that, fair enough, this the game is rigged, but also allow me to play my game on my side, right? That's the only problem, because they'd kind of relegate these sort of nights to the bars and clubs, and it'd let all the commercial DJs kind of populate all the clubs, and there's no way of you kind of breaking in there. And also for the punters, it's boring because there's no way to kind of get fresh new people playing in front of you. It's always the same old boring people. So the fact that they're doing this is incredible. They're giving them the platform. And of course, when they get given the platform, guess what they do? They fucking throw that shit out of the park. I miss the shows, whatever, because usually they have like a little performance show. It's always amazing. They have a really cool artist, performance artist doing it, doing interesting pieces, whatnot. They have great DJs who they don't really announce before, ahead of time, I don't think. It's usually people like friends and family. And then, of course, the people that attend are dressed to the nines. Like, this is legitimate club kid shit. And again, it's so... I guess I was so unprepared because, again, I'm a fucking club nightlife, you know, fiend. But because of all the books and accounts and interviews I've read from the past, it feels like this is like a bygone era, right? The club kid thing kind of has gone away. But for whatever reason, in the last few years, there's been a resurgence of this kind of performance aspect when it comes to going out. This kind of need to express yourself and your ideologies and your view on life and your moods and your passions through your clothing. This idea that, you know, clubbing isn't just about going out and getting smacked and, you know, whatever. Going out and getting flipping high as a flipping kite and hooking up with random strangers. Of course, some of that is probably still happening, but there is another part of it, which is just this pure liberation, the ability to kind of be in a space with people that are just like you, share similar interests, and kind of be in a quote-unquote, what would you say, safe space, right? A place that you can kind of be your unbridled or authentic self, you know, to the max. And they're doing it to the absolute max. And I have to be honest, it was absolutely banging, man, all of it. Okay, they have the lineup here, but I missed that. But yeah, banging. Really, really, really good. I absolutely enjoyed it, man. I really had a good time. I met so many cool people. Added a few people on Instagram here and there. For the people that I was annoying by telling you how amazing you were dressed and how underdressed I felt, please excuse me. That was just my insecurities coming out. You know, when you're insecure, you try and self-deprecate yourself to an extent where it just gets a bit annoying. So I know that was happening quite often. But I was just sat down for the most part. I spent some time on the stage. Then I spent some time at the bar, talking to the bartenders, just kind of observing and kind of soaking it all in. And wow, man, what a great night. Honestly, I cannot have any more good words to say about Inferno. Like I said, if you're interested or if you're kind of just bored of the regular club scene and you want to see what's kind of going on in London's, I wouldn't say underbelly, because I really do believe these sort of like next set of promoters that are coming up at the moment are going to be the next sort of wave who kind of dictate the next sort of flow of what's going on in clubland. I think overall people are going to get bored of the same old business techno DJs playing in the same old places, because again, they have a purpose. I think when you go to shows like in Printworks, you see where those kind of DJs kind of have a purpose, right? In those kind of platforms, those kind of space, even some of that Fabric, that there's platforms and places where it's kind of necessary to see those people play at those sort of stages because they really know how to do those stages really well. But then also the other spaces, I would also like to see some variety. I want to see somebody different that's on a DJ lamp, somebody new that I haven't heard of, different people in the space surrounded by you. There's nothing better than that, especially for me, who's, again, a guy who's gone to the Colour Factory, formerly Mixed Garage, for a long, long time. To be in that space, be surrounded by people that I've never seen that space beforehand was really cool. I have to be honest, really, 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 really cool. And I really recommend you check it out. When I went, of course, it was interesting too, a little bit of an end to end it there. It was a bit of a mindfuck to go to a London club and have a door picker. That was absolutely really cool. So there was this girl who was at the door, making sure no kind of randoms got in. As I was approaching, unfortunately, a big group of like white dudes tried to get in, and she said, obviously, no, you know, just to kind of make sure they protect the space and make sure the people who are in there kind of feel comfortable, because they didn't want too many, I guess, hetero vibes in there, which I completely understand. Luckily, they permitted me to go in. I think it helped because I was on my own. Don't get me wrong. Maybe the skin color helped too. I don't think so. I'd like to think not. I just think because I was on my own and I was kind of well behaved and I looked maybe like a kind of blend in, that maybe I was allowed to go in. That was great. But it was a bit of a mindfuck to see a door picker in London, because we don't have that culture at all, which is why our club scene is a bit, you know, hit and miss. It's something obviously they do in Berlin really well and in other sort of places around Europe. But that idea of like making sure you kind of cultivate the space and ensure that people in there feel comfortable, because essentially we're in their house, isn't it? This is their house. It's not my house. This is their house. I'm a guest. So I just want to make sure that they don't feel like, you know, you're impeding in anything. And wow, man, I have to be honest, wow, what an incredibly fun night. I have to be honest, really, really fun night. I was gutted it ended too quickly. Ended at 4 a.m. I only got there like 12:30, I think. So my L in that regard. Can't wait to go again. When I do go, I'm going to get dressed up. gonna put on some face paint, have an amazing outfit on, and really go crazy, because it definitely is a place for you to kind of explore and kind of tap into some of your more expressive and more out there side of yourself in terms of what you wear when you go out and the attitude that you have, the way that you dance, everything around that. Just I just don't have any more good words to say about it, man. So big up Inferno, big up that crew. Cannot wait to go to another one.